الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي
سبحانه وتعالى نحمده سبحانه we praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه and we seek Allah سبحانه وتعالى's help and support ونستغفره and we seek Allah سبحانه وتعالى's forgiveness ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا and we seek refuge in Allah from the evils of our actions and the evils of our soul. مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهِ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهِ Anyone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide to the right path, no one can misguide. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهِ And anyone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguide, no one can guide. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهِ And I testify there is nothing worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the slave of Allah and his last messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonish you the believers, saying with a soft approach, after he created you, give you everything that you want without paying for it. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أيها believing in Allah تقوا الله حق تقاته fear Allah as he should be feared ولا تموتن do not die don't let death comes to you إلا وأنتم مسلمون except as a believer or as a Muslim this tells you that you should hold fast to this deen. There is nothing like this deen on this planet. Allah says, and another verse, Ya أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O you who believe in Allah, تَقُوا اللَّهَ فِيَ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا And say the right word, good words. What is the result? What is the reward? If you keep saying the truth, being honest to one another, what is the reward? If everyone trusts you as a man, as a woman that always say the truth, Allah say, if you do that, يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ, He will perfect in your deeds. Everyone loves you because you say the truth, honest. Everyone would like to work with you because you don't cheat on them or you don't cheat them. Or if you've been known as a man that will cheat each and every individual that works with you, no one would like to work with you. And this is this world. Allah will perfect in your deeds. Makes people love you to work with you all the time. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And in the year after, He will forgive you your sins. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Anyone that who obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow the commandment of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا عَظِيمًا. Indeed, he has succeeded in a great success. After the prayer, فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. There is no doubt. Indeed, the best speech, the best word, Kitabullah, is the word of Allah, is the book of Allah. Wa khayr al hadi, and the best guidance of humanity on the surface of the planet, Hadi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no doubt that the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best guidance of humanity. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعُ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُسْلِيهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ, anyone that opposes the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the guidance have come clear to him, وَيَتَّبِعَ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and he decided to follow other than the way of the believers, the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى, we will let him stay in what he chooses for himself. What's going to be the reward after he has chosen something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not told him to follow? Allah say, وَنُصْلِيهِ جَهَنَّمْ, he will be burning to the hell fire. نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. May Allah protect us from being brought to the hell fire. وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا, and what a bad return. Straight to our topic. Today, inshallah, I would like to discuss with you أَدِلَّةُ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ عَلَى ثُبُوتِ عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ. Justifications from the word of Allah and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that tells us, yes, the punishment of the grave, it is something mandatory. It is compulsory. Allah has said it. It is a reality that the punishment of the grave, it will happen. Why are we discussing about this? Because some of us, yes, we are Muslim, but do we believe, yes, the punishment of the grave is a reality? Some of us who don't believe in it. That's why we do what we do. We behave the way we behave. Especially we that live in some part of this world. We live as Muslim, but wallahi, some of us, we don't believe in Adab al-Qadr. We don't believe in it. And yesterday you may know, even some of the disbelievers, they believe in Adab al-Qadr. But we think only the Muslim believe in Adab al-Qadr. Adab al-Qabr is a reality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ عَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Allah says, we'll make them taste the minor punishment without the major punishment. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. They may return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, they may repent and fear Allah. قَالَ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنَ الْمُفَسِّرِينَ. Some of the scholars of tafsir, or the science of the Quran, they says, أَنَّ الْعَذَابَ الْأَدْنَى هُوَ عَذَابُ الْبَرْزَقِ قَبْلَ عَذَابِ الْآخِرَةِ. They said the meaning of this minor punishment here, the meaning means is the punishment that we're going to have in our grave before the Yawm Al-Qiyamah. وَقِيلَ عَذَابُ الْأَدْنَى هِيَ عَذَابُ الدُّنْيَا قَبْلَ عَذَابِ الْآخِرَةِ. And some of them said, the عَذَابُ الْأَدْنَى, the minor punishment, is the punishment of this dunya before the punishment of the Day of Judgment. Allah says, النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيًّا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَدْخِلُوا أَهْلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. Allah says, النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا. They will be brought up into the hellfire. غُدُوًا, in the morning, وَعَشِيًّا, in the afternoon. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, and the day of resurrection, قِيَامَةِ, Allah will say, أَدْخِلُوا أَهْلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. Put the peoples of Fir'aun in the painful torment. This is Yawm Al-Qiyamah. A pause. Allah says, He will bring them to the punishment day and night. That's the Azab al-Barzakh, when you are in your grave. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, and the day of the resurrection, Allah will say, أَدْخِلُوا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. Put Fir'aun into the painful punishment. وَلِذَا كَانَ ابْنُ عَمَرَ كَمَا فِي الرِّوَايَةِ الصَّحِيحَةِ عَنْهُ يَقُولُ إِذَا أَمْسَى الْمَسَاءُ أَقْبَلَ اللَّيْلِ وَأَدْبَرَ النَّهَارُ وَعُرِضَ أَهْلُ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى النَّارِ. Ibn Umar said, in an authentic narration, he used to say, if the evening comes and the night follow, and the day goes, وَأُرِدَ أَهْلُ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى النَّارِ, Fir'aun's people will be brought to the hellfire. فالأحاديث في ثبوت عذاب القبر كثيرة منها. The ahadith that tells us about the punishment of عذاب القبر, it is a lot, and most of them are authentic. We're going to choose some of them. ومن ذلك وجاء في حديث أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها أنها دخلت عليها يهودية فاستطعمتها فلما أطعمها تمرة قالت يهودية لأم المؤمنين عائشة أعاذك الله من عذاب القبر. هذه يهودية ففزعت عائشة من قولها. فلما دخل عليها رسول الله قالت يا رسول الله قد جاءتني يهودية. فلما ذكرت عائشة الخبر نزل الوحي تلا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال هل شعرت أنه أوحي إلي أنكم تفتنون في قبوركم كفتنة الدجال أو أشد. So this hadith that we're going to mention, أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها, the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, a يهودية, Jewish lady, came to her house asking for food. يطلب الطعام. After the أم المؤمنين رضي الله عنها, he gives her the food or the dates according to the hadith. He gives her what she requested for. And the يهودية أعاذك الله من عذاب القبر. And she said, may Allah protect you from the punishment of the grave. This is Yahudiya. May Allah protect Umm Aisha from the punishment of the grave. This is Yahudiya. She's praying for Umm Aisha. May Allah protect her from the punishment of the grave. This tells you, there are people who believe in the Adab al-Qadr. But yet me and you, we are Muslims. Do we believe in it? You have some of us asking questions. If I die by burning into the fire, how Allah will resurrect me? You don't ask those questions. You were nothing before Allah created you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take you, wipe you off. He's going to seize you and make you nothing. Because by you being in your grave, you're going to be nothing. Then, when she said that, Fafaziyat Ummul Mu'mineen, Aisha, she got surprised from her statement in Qawli. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered to her house, and she, Ummul Mu'mineen, she narrated the story. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked her, did you know that it has been revealed to me that annakum tuftanuna fi quburikum, you will be tested in your grave like the fitna of Dajjal, or more than the fitna of Dajjal in the grave. We'll be punished more than the punishment that we're going to have in the grave. It might be more than the test of Dajjal that will come at the end of this world and get a lot of us to follow. قالت عائشة رضي الله عنها فوالله ما رأيت صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى صلاة إلا استعاذ بالله فيها من عذاب القبر. She said, since that day, I never saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم praying an obligatory prayer except he seek refuge from the punishment of the grave. That is why, when you finish your tashahhud, al-akhir, the last tashahhud before you end your prayer, you seek refuge from adab al-qadr. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من عذاب القبر ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال. This dua, after you finish your tashahhud al-akhir, before you end the prayer, you make this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to seek refuge in the punishment of the grave. If the punishment of the grave is not a reality, why should the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seek refuge from it? وفي في الحديث الصحيح in an authentic hadith the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ta'awadhu billahi min adhab al-qabr three times he said seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave wa qasaha an-nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi sahihain that is reported that the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith which is in sahihain when we say sahihain means sahih al-bukhari and sahih muslim min hadith ibn abbas from the hadith of ibn abbas radiyallahu ta'ala an ibn abbas min abdullah ibn abbas انه صلى الله عليه وسلم مر the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed by قبرين two graves فوقف and he stopped وقال and he said انهما لا يعذبان indeed these two people that in this grave لا يعذبان they have been punished وَمَا يُعَذَّبَانِ فِي كَبِيرٍ And they are not being punished because of a major sin في رواية in a narration. In another narration, بَلَا إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرٌ It is, they are punished because of a major sin. وَأَمَّا أَحْدُهُمَا And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم started explaining. You know, when you teach people You get the ways how to teach them so that they will understand. If the prophet said these people are punished, and without teaching them in this way, they wouldn't understand it. And he said, one of them, فَكَانَ يَمْشِي بِالنَّمِيمَةِ One of these people that are punished in this grave, or these graves, he used to set fire between people. Destroying between people. What some of us do all the time. Set fire in one another, brothers and sisters, husband and wife. Especially some of our mothers. When we come to the West, they want their daughters to bring a lot of money for them back home. Meaning, don't listen to the husband what he says. Try to get a job and bring for us letters as well. We're depending on you. You know, they don't say they're depending on Allah. After telling your own daughter to go and look for a job, remember that she got married to somebody that brought her here. So you need to listen to her. By doing this, you are set fire in the two people. If the husband don't want his wife to work, he don't have to work. She has to listen. It is her agenda. Apart from that, this one used to set fire people. وَأَمَّا الْآخَرُ And what about the other one that's been punished? فَكَانَ لَا يَسْتَبْرِئُ أَيْ لَا يَسْتَطِرُ مِنْ بَوْلِ He was not cleaning himself when he urinated. وَهَذَا عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُمَا مُسْلِمَيْنَ Why these people are punished? Because they're Muslims. We're going to know why. This man, the one that was not cleaning himself from urinating, why is he being punished? Does that make sense? If I'm not cleaning myself from my urine, why should Allah punish me? Because somebody asked this question. Come on, I'm not cleaning myself, so I'm just, it's fine. So from there, أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ I said what I have said, seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He must forgive me, must merciful. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد Now we know the one that set fire people destroys relation who will never make peace so this we know that is a sin even though if it happens for the mother-in-laws or the father-in-laws to destroy that marriage They have sinned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have the right to give your daughter to a husband who you don't have the right to take her back by force. No. وأما الذي كان لا يستبرئ من بوله. Why the one that was not cleaning himself from his urine? Why is he being punished? One, فهذا يبطل صلاته. This destroys, nullifies his salah. When he urinates, you don't clean yourself, and that runs into your trousers, and you stand and pray in front of Allah with the urine, your salah is nullified because your trousers is not clean. Both sides, sisters and brothers, remember that. It's not clean. You stand in front of Allah. وَقَدْ ضَيَّ حَقَّ اللَّهِ فِي الطَّهَارَةِ. He has neglected the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hygiene path. He's not cleaning himself. How many of us do that? Well, we don't clean ourselves, then we just take the same trousers and pray. That's wrong in ourselves. You know, clean, you pray, say, no, I'm clean, but you don't know. That's why we clean ourselves properly whenever we urinate. If this man is being punished for this, because he's not giving Allah's rights. He's not cleaning himself. And he stand and pray without him being clean or healed. I see some people are looking the time, inshallah, I'll finish in a minute. Hatta fasadat alayhi salatu, and until his salah is being nullified. فما على المسلم إلا أن يؤمن بعذاب القبر. So I will cut it short because some people are looking the time. So therefore, the obligatory upon you, the Muslim, except nothing else, except you have to believe in the عذاب القبر, إيمان كامل, a complete belief. أنه لا شك فيه ولا مريه, there is no doubt on it. It will happen. والله على كل شيء قدير. Allah is able to do everything. وهذا هو الاستسلام لله تعالى والإيمان. You have to submit yourself to Allah سبحانه وتعالى and have a complete belief. يسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي. They are asking you about the soul. Say the soul is Allah سبحانه وتعالى knows about it. So He will do it the way He wants. So if they ask Allah about the soul, He controls the soul, He do whatever with the soul, for Him to punish you in the grave, is that something hard? It's not hard. It is very, very easy for Him. اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين والمسلمات اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم 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 ووسل قلبهم واغسلهم بالماء والثلج البرد ونقهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الابيض من الدنس يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين والمسلمات الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانيه وبنبيك بالرساله وماتوا على ذلك اللهم ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وأقيموا الصلاة